Hi, I'm Sarah Bennett, office manager and wedding coordinator here at Peace. Here are some ways to stay connected. Join us this Thursday for worship at 7 p.m. in the sanctuary. Maundy Thursday is the memorial of the Last Supper with the disciples, and we use this story of the First Communion as a base for our youth's First Communion. Join our youth as they take this important step in their faith. Join us Friday at 7 p.m. in the sanctuary for our Good Friday worship. Good Friday marks the crucifixion, the slaying of the Lamb of God. This meaningful worship experience is our final moment of reflection before the resurrection. Next Sunday, there are three opportunities to worship with us for Easter. We invite you to try our sunrise worship in the Memorial Garden. This will take place during the sunrise at 6:45 a.m. Our traditional Easter worship service will be held in the sanctuary at 9, or you can join us for our contemporary worship at 10:30 in the Connection Center. Come celebrate the resurrection with the coming of the new day. Save the date. Peace Serves will take place on Sunday, April 21st. Peace Serves is an annual day of service for our faith community. After worship, a sack lunch is distributed, and then we disperse to various locations throughout Central Ohio to serve. All ages are welcome to volunteer for a wide variety of service opportunities, including both indoor and outdoor projects. More information will be coming soon. To support Peace's ongoing outreach ministries, remember these ways to give. You can donate online at peacegehanna.org. You can text PLCG to 73256. You can drop donations in our offering basket any Sunday during worship, or you can mail in your donation. You can learn more about our community, including upcoming events, groups, and classes, at peacegehanna.org, or follow us at peacegehanna. You can also stay connected by signing up for our weekly newsletters and prayer line by visiting our website. We are glad you are with us today. We are Peace Lutheran Church. Our mission, to love God, neighbor, and self.
Good morning. Welcome to our Palm Sunday worship, just another typical Sunday here at Peace Lutheran Church. We're glad that you're here. If you're a guest with us today, welcome. We're thrilled to have you with us and invite you to come back next week for our Easter service. A few notes about this service. As you can guess, it's very meditative, and it's a great way to get into the Passion story. So we ask you to hold your applause until the end of the service. There are seven acts throughout this. If you haven't already noticed, this bulletin is hugely helpful because it will describe everything that you're hearing, because all of it is in Latin. And then as you come up today for communion, we'll be handing out the palms. So at the end of the service, we'll be processing out with your palms and having our Palm Sunday celebration then. So I ask you now to just settle in, maybe take a deep breath, and put yourself in the moment of this amazing service.
Hi, I'm Jen Guthrie. I'm a Trinity Lutheran Seminary student serving and member here at Peace. We've been practicing breath prayers throughout the Lent season, and this morning is no exception. The breath prayers allow us a time to settle in, to be able to spend some quiet time with God and focus on our breath and become steady and sure of where we are. As we prepare for this week, where we remember the different events of the last week of Jesus' life here on earth before his death, we have a lot of different things going on. We have the Maundy Thursday service, we have today the Palm Sunday service, then Good Friday, and then next week Easter. And so my prayer for all of you and for me today is, as we prepare our hearts to walk through this week with Christ. So go ahead and close your eyes or cast a downward gaze if you feel more comfortable with that. And as you inhale the phrase, prepare my heart. And then exhale the phrase, to walk with you. Inhale, prepare my heart, and exhale to walk with you. Now take some time during the prelude and just breathe. Prepare my heart to walk with you. The beginning of the good news about Jesus the Messiah, Son of God, as it is written in Isaiah the prophet. I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. A voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him.
Thank you.
Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Simon and his companions went to look for him. When they found him, they exclaimed, "Everyone is looking for you." Jesus replied, "Come, let us go somewhere else, to nearby villages, so I can preach there also. That is why I have come."
Thank you.
Again, the high priest asked him, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?" "I am," said Jesus. "And you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven." As Jesus was leaving the temple, one of his disciples said to him, "Look, teacher, what massive stones, what massive buildings. Do you see all these great buildings?" replied Jesus. "Not one stone here will be left on another. Everyone will be thrown down."
Almighty and loving God, on this blessed Palm Sunday, we come before you with hearts full of gratitude and praise. We thank you for the gift of beautiful music which touches our souls and lifts our spirits as we celebrate the triumphant entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. We are reminded of the power of music to convey the depths of human emotion and the glory of your divine presence. We are grateful for composers like Fauré, who through his Requiem captured the essence of hope and peace amidst sorrow and longing. In the words of the Requiem, we find solace and reassurance, knowing that you are with us in times of joy and sorrow, guiding us with your eternal love. As we journey through Holy Week, we eagerly anticipate the promise of Easter, the victory of light over darkness, of life over death. May the music we hear and the prayers we offer be a testament to our faith in your redeeming grace, and grant us the strength to follow in the footsteps of Jesus, to embrace the challenges of discipleship, and to share your love with all whom we encounter. May the melodies of Palm Sunday lead us to the glorious chorus of Easter morning, where we will join with all creation in singing your praises forever and ever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Very early in the morning, the chief priests with the elders, the teachers of the law, and the whole Sanhedrin made their plans. So they bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. "Are you the king of the Jews?" asked Pilate. "You have said so," Jesus replied.
Thank you.
So there's the celebration and the joy of the king arriving into Jerusalem, people waving their palms. And yet in less than a week, that same king would be nailed to a tree. Yet in between, there is this meal, a meal where Jesus dines with his disciples, disciples who would betray him, disciples that would abandon him, and yet the promise is still given, the promise of forgiveness, the promise of new life. It's in the night in which he was betrayed that our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, he gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took a cup, gave thanks, and he poured it out for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." And we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our table is set, and all of you are invited to come and be a part of this meal where Christ is the host. If you're a guest, please know you're welcome. We celebrate an open table here at Peace. The way that we'll do communion is just come down the center aisle. You'll be handed the body of Christ, dip it into the wine, the blood of Christ, eating the elements together, and return through the side aisles. If you need gluten-free wafers or pre-filled grape juice, they're on this table up front. And there's also an offering plate if you came today prepared to make an offering. We thank you because it goes toward the ongoing outreach ministries that Peace is a part of. Or if you've given online, as so many of you do, thank you. It really does make a difference. We'll commune our worship assistants first and then spread the meal out to all of you.
Thank you.
The soldiers led Jesus away into the palace, that is the praetorium, and called together the whole company of soldiers. They put a purple robe on him, then twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on him. And then they began to call out to him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" Again and again they struck him on the head with a staff and spit on him. Falling on their knees, they paid homage to him. And when they had mocked him, they took off the purple robe and put on his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him.
Thank you.
At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. And at 3 in the afternoon, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, my God, why have you forsaken me?
I love that. It ends so simply, yet so beautifully. Let's have a few words of thanks. Can we say thank you to our conductor, Jason Heisler, for being here this morning? Say thank you to our soprano, Hannah Bullock. And our baritone, Ortega Wright. Our instrumentalists back here. And your Peace Lutheran Church Choir. And finally, this guy named Q Jones. Let's do it again next week. All right, so I'm going to have you stand now. We're going to say these sending words. Our choir is going to process out first, and then we all can follow them as they go, waving our palms. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heavens.